In this video, we'll cover the basics of Wrike so you can structure your workspace. Wrike has four main building blocks: spaces, folders, projects, and tasks. The first step in organizing your workspace is to set up spaces. Think of a space as a place that unites people, tools, and work assets under a theme. You can set up a space per team, a space per client, a space per region, or whatever works best for you. Let's begin by adding a new space, which will be a top-level element for organizing the work of the marketing team. We click the plus icon at the top panel of the workspace and select Space. First, we need to give it a name. Let's name it after our team, Marketing. Next, we invite team members to the space. If they haven't joined the account yet, we can invite them by typing their email addresses into this field. They will receive invitations to join your Wrike account and will become members of the new space you created. We finish by clicking the Create button. The space is added to your Wrike workspace. Now we're inside our marketing space. Let's add some structure to the new space and think about how your work is categorized. Usually, the projects a team is working on can be divided into several groups based on their type, urgency, client, or another way. We're going to use folders to represent these categories. Think of folders as buckets used to organize your space. We'll add folders for digital projects and for print materials. We click this plus icon to the right of the section name, select Folder, and give it a name. Let's add our first project to the digital folder. A project usually contains several tasks connected to a single goal with a deadline. We right-click the digital folder, hover over Add, and choose Project. We need to give our project a name. We'll use Webinar and set start and due dates. As you can see, our project has its own attributes, including status, owner, and start and finish dates. It's easy to distinguish our project from folders on the left panel because it has a small clipboard icon. Once the project is created, we need to populate it with the tasks that are required to complete it. For example, what do we need to do for a webinar? We need to write a script, send invitations, prepare slides, run the webinar, and collect stats. All the tasks are ready, and it's time to assign them. We recommend assigning each task to a single person so it's crystal clear who's responsible for what. Now we need to schedule the tasks to make sure everyone understands the deadlines and can prioritize their tasks accordingly. The Gantt chart view is one of the best views to use to allocate your tasks and time. For tasks to appear there, they need to be scheduled, so I'm using mass actions to quickly schedule them for today. Now that we can see all the tasks on the Gantt chart, we can easily set their duration. The next step is interconnecting tasks with dependencies. There are two main reasons to do that. First, if the tasks are interconnected, Wrike considers the project a single entity, not a set of random independent tasks. So if you need to reschedule a task, all the consequent ones are rescheduled accordingly. Second, dependencies help everyone to know exactly when they need to start working on their tasks. Once the previous task is marked as completed, the person responsible for the next task will be automatically notified that they can now start working on it. The final step to launch the project is to convert the critical event into a milestone. That's the run the webinar task in our case. Milestones are one-day tasks that are tied to critical events like new feature launches, conferences, order submission, or contract sign dates. Even if we change the due dates of other tasks, the milestone won't be rescheduled. Now everyone on the team knows who needs to do what by when. And we can kick off our project. But how do we know where things stand at any given moment? Let's add a team dashboard that will help us monitor work progress. We click the plus button, select Dashboard, give it a name, and click Create. Now let's fill the dashboard with widgets. A widget shows a list of tasks, projects, or files based on the criteria you specify. For this dashboard, we'll create a widget with the lists of tasks assigned to each team member. We can use this pre-built template. Select a team member from the list and choose the space. Let's repeat that for the rest of the team. Let's also add a widget for unassigned tasks. We select this custom widget, give it a name, specify the space, and apply the unassigned filter. Now the dashboard is ready. It will help you evaluate team workload and quickly adjust it by dragging tasks between widgets. You can add other dashboards depending on your needs. If you have a business subscription or above, you can set up Wrike calendars to plan product launches, events, email campaigns, or similar types of work. For example, here's a calendar for upcoming webinars. All space members and new users who join the space will automatically have access to these tools. Thanks for your time. Have a productive day.